know, for our specific group, which includes currently 4 junior performance majors, and you'll get to meet all of us at the end of the concert, if you like. The concert itself is actually our final project for the Petrie 360 course, which is a required class for all junior music majors taking in the upcoming fall 2021. Petrie 360 is a class designed to give students the opportunity to obtain skills such as marketing, graphic designing for posters, flyers, and social media promotions, contracting professional musicians, booking venues, writing grants, and programming repertoire, among many other responsibilities. This concert has entailed all of those things, and it's been quite a challenge for us to figure out how to make all these things work in such a short amount of time, but I have to say it's been one of the most rewarding experiences for us this semester. And on that note, I think it's time to get the show started. So if you'll take a look in your program, we did have one slight change. Professor Ann Danbo and Dr. Keith Jones will not be joining us tonight. They had to cancel. And so we will be ending with third wheel. If you would please help me in giving a hand for our musicians, they have graciously volunteered their time and their talents to give us a peek into what being a married musician is really like. I hope you all enjoy, and thank you again for coming.
Mozart's last opera that he wrote, The Magic Flute, has all kinds of deep, deep pondering themes. Enlightenment versus ignorance, truth versus falsehood, good versus evil. And then there's Papageno, who doesn't really care about any of that. All he wants is good food, good drink, preferably wine, and just maybe to find the perfect match for him. Finally, near the end of the opera, Papageno finds his Papagena.
Now you will be mine forever.
I will be yours forever.
Come and be my little starling.
I will be your little starling.
My little starling, my little starling. What a joy for us is near.
What a joy for us is near.
And the gods they're bound to show.
And the gods they're bound to show. Lots of children
they will bring us. Lots of children they will send us. Will send us tiny children dear. Children dear.
Children dear.
Children dear. Such lovely, tiny children dear. Such lovely, tiny children dear. First comes a little Papageno. Then comes another Papageno.
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 It is the greatest joy of any.
It is the greatest joy of any.
And
many Papageno's. Papageno's. Papageno's upon their parents' blessing ring. Papageno, 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 Papageno's upon their parents' blessing ring.
Papageno,
Papageno, Papageno's upon their parents' blessing ring. Upon their parents' blessing ring. Upon their parents' blessing ring.
Duet, which is actually originally written for clarinet and bassoon, but I won't be playing the clarinet part on the bassoon. I'll be playing the double bass and what was originally the bassoon part. We found an arrangement for two cellos, but we decided to arrange it even further for our instruments. And I'm Matt Wade, an adjunct bass teacher here at Converse, so we hope you enjoy the piece. Thank you.
Dolly Suite by Fauré. Fauré was not one to like descriptive titles for his instrumental works. He liked titles like Nocturne or Barcarolle, things like that. But there are a couple of exceptions, and this is one of them. The Dolly Suite has 6 movements, and he wrote this for his mistress's daughter. Special occasions, he would write a piece, and this was a birthday celebration, and we're going to play the first movement of the Dolly Suite, Berceuse, and it's a lullaby, and I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Presents specials, this was featured as the theme music for that. And I have arranged this, I originally arranged it for a double reed quartet when I was in Cincinnati, and then I've reduced it further into a duo for bassoon and double bass. So I've reduced a reduction. Hope you enjoy.
Familiar one. Sky and Sarah meet. They have nothing in common. They come from different worlds. They have different values, and they really don't like each other. And in the time-honored tradition of musicals and movies and stories forever, they do fall in love. This song they sing when they have really just realized that they have fallen in love. My husband and I realized that about 37 years ago, and we've had the chance to sing a lot of things together, and we always enjoy performing together, and I hope you enjoy it too.
As your programs have told you, Thea Musgrave is still alive, Scottish-born composer. This is a thorny, prickly little atonal piece, but it's also super fun. And you'll see as we go through this that often the parts are going along in perfect unison, often they're kind of mocking each other in very close atonal counterpoint, and often they're completely doing their own things without even any sort of notated rhythm. It's a really fun little piece, hope you enjoy it.
15 years, and we have two children. Our little girl just turned 9 yesterday, and our son will turn 4 next month.
Yeah. Like you said, we've been married 10 years, but we have known each other for 17 years. We met while we were doing our undergrad at USC in Columbia for music education, and we have been music educators since we graduated. I've taught for 12 years in the public school systems, and he's been teaching for 10 years. So, but this year I stayed home with the kids, just as you all know, to navigate this our life in the pandemic and try and keep them safe. But I hope to return to teaching very soon. We have actually never performed together on violin and tuba. We have performed on violin and guitar. So this is actually quite fun for us tonight to be able to perform for you. We are going to play a piece called Tango 8 by Jeremy Cohen. It's actually a violoncello duet because for some reason there's just not a lot of violin and tuba music, and we're not really sure why, because we think it's a wonderful combination, just like our marriage. So, but we're excited to play this for you tonight. We hope you enjoy it.
Mozart composed this when he was 16 to play on tour with his sister Nannerl when they were touring around as young prodigies. So it was written for four-hand piano, and we'll be playing the third movement, the Allegro Molto, and it's a really fun movement. There's lots of almost comic conversations between the two parts, so enjoy.
Thank you. performers, we'd like to thank very much the members of the Canon Ensemble, as well as Daley Pruitt, for all of their work in putting on this concert. They've been a real pleasure to work with, and it's so cool to watch our students learn all of these cool and interesting things. So, as you probably figured out from the everything, the whole theme here was married couples coming to play together. But, you know, sometimes you have a married couple, and then, well, a third comes along.